welcome back to Richard Digance and Friends, and this is the moment I'm sure most of you have been waiting for, apart from my fans, of course. This is indeed a great favour to me, and I think for you, because this is the first time Jethro Tull have ever appeared acoustically, and when I rang Ian Anderson up to do it, who's an old friend of mine, he said, "Yes, Roger, I'd love to do it for you." Anyway, I'd like to introduce this outfit to you individually. They're all very, very good chums, and they've all done an equally big favour for me tonight. On the abortive... what?
That's a big word for you, Roger.
Yeah, I know, Roger.
Right again.
On the portative abortive organ, would you give a nice welcome, please, to a man whose hobby is bricklaying? David Palmer. And for those of you at home, you're listening now in the left-hand speaker. We're coming along now to your sideboard, where we have, on drums, one of my very best mates and tennis partner. And he's, I don't know what his other hobby is, standing on boxes, Mr. Barrymore Barlow. On very big bass guitar, come casserole, we have... a gentleman, the newest member of Jethro Tull, who very nearly did this show a little while ago with Simon Nicol. His hobby is drinking and playing darts. Dave Pegg. Right. Normally on loud electric guitar, but now very subtly on a smaller guitar, or a mandolin, in fact. A man whose hobbies are sailing and buying farms. To please welcome Martin Barr. And usually on the old Joanna, but tonight on an upright Joanna, very upright and squeezed. Nice welcome, please, to John Evans. And the man who put it all together for me, a nice welcome, please, for, well, he makes fish. Ian Anderson.
Good, that's very kind of you. I should add at this point that we've just finished a rather lengthy tour around the European continent. This is a song called Jackie and the Green, which is about the character who's supposed to look after all the green things and keep them alive until the renewal in spring. Barry told me about that. He's into that sort of thing, actually. You got it. One, two, three.
Have you seen Jack in the Green? With his long chain hanging down. He quietly sits under every tree. In the folds of his velvet gown, he drinks from an empty acorn cup. And the dew that dawns sweetly bestows, and taps his cane upon the ground. Signals the stone drums, it's time to go out. The colors all the summer song, yeah. He carries a green flag on the winter lawn. Behind.
This is a song which wasn't written by any of us, but it was written by Dave Pegg before he joined Jethro Tull. This is one of Dave's instrumental pieces. You know, he used to play with the Fairport Convention, and those of you who are interested in acquiring a copy of this will find it on one of their albums. We had to borrow it to learn it. And it's optimistically titled, since Dave's main interests, as Roger told you earlier, are drinking and dancing. This is optimistically titled Peggy's Pub.
Okay.
Welcome back to Richard Digance and Friends on my favourite, definitely my favourite show, each week. I forgot to mention actually that Tull and I have actually been at Hammersmith Odeon for what, five nights, was it?
It was indeed, yeah.
Must have been a good film. Right. Anyway, would you welcome back Jethro Tull?
The song we're going to play is one which originates from the part of the world I now inhabit from time to time, and since it's one all about the general inclemency of the weather, I thought who better to introduce it than your very own, from upstairs, Mr. Francis Wilson, the weatherman of Thames Television. A big hand.
The weather's on the change.
ice clouds invading, lines joining to paint discord, and the storm watch brews a concert of kings as the white sea snaps at the squeals of a soft prayer whisper.
As I miss the other day, slip the knife from shame and make a mark on the lane. Call twilight hours down from a heaven home. High above the high spitter
for the good.
I'll meet you down by the Ringill. On we'll watch the old gods believe. Oh, by the Ringill. Oh, by the Ringill. Wait till he starts and goes.
Till the forest
comes through.
That we've been playing for 3 years or so, and it's usually a very loud one on stage. It's very, very difficult now to play this way. And Barry, as you can see, has taken over the very large bass there. He's moving into it next week, I think. This one's called Heavy Horses. Here we go, then.
I'm clad in a beast and in the dust, an October's day. Sweating balls, veins, standing in front of the flag. Salt on a beach, yes, sees me. Last of a line, pattern on his face. Thank you.
Jethro Tull.